my channel. I'm Melody, a romance and YA author, and I think I just want to sit down and do a little chatty video. I have some hot chocolate that I made, and of course I put marshmallows in it because you can't have hot chocolate without marshmallows. They did not have the kind with the little mini marshmallows. Like, they were completely sold out in the grocery store. I guess supply chain issues. I don't know. But that's okay because I can have my own marshmallows, and these are bigger anyway. This is so, so good. Do I have chocolate on my mouth? It'd be like really embarrassing if I did this video and I had like a ton of chocolate on my mouth. Maybe that wasn't a good idea to drink this at the same time of doing this video. So it's a new year, and it makes me think about where I was exactly 2 years ago. Exactly 2 years ago, I was thinking about what I wanted my goals for the new year to be, what my plans, what my publishing plans were going to be. And I remember 2 years ago, I was so, so certain that I was going to get a literary agent. I was going to be published. Like, that was the path I was going to be on. And I had even wrote it down in my notebook that my goal for 2019 was to get a literary agent. But as you know, that did not happen. I ended up deciding that was not the path for me. And I think I just wanted to talk a little bit about that. And before I get into this, I don't want you to think that this is some kind of video that says self-publishing is better than traditional publishing. Honestly, I really just feel like they're just two sides of the same coin. You know, there's pros and cons to each one. Each path is fine. You just have to decide what is right for you. And what I eventually decided was that self-publishing was the way to go. I decided that traditional publishing was not for me. And I just wanted to talk a little bit about how I came to that decision. So I already did a video about why I decided to self-publish. And this isn't going to be the same video. This is going to be just a little bit different. Because I wanted to talk about how I felt personally about when it came to my dreams of being published. And yes, I did have these dreams of having a literary agent and being published by the Big Five and all that. But what I eventually realized was that if I wanted to do traditional publishing, if that was the way I wanted to pursue my publishing dream, it was going to take a long, long time. It was going to take a long time. You have to think about how long it takes. I mean, it just can take forever. I was on Twitter a few weeks ago, and there was someone who made a tweet. They said that she had been waiting for 7 years. After 7 years of querying, she finally got a literary agent. And I was like, oh my God, that is a long, long time to query. That is such a long time. I don't think that I would have waited that long. Now, if that's the way you want to go, if you want to publish traditionally, that's, you know, never give up. Don't give up. But I don't think I could wait that long. I wanted to publish my book. That's all. I just wanted to publish my book. I wanted to get my book out there in the world. I wanted to have a book with my name on it. And I don't think I could wait 7 years. And if you think about this, okay, so if it takes you a long time to get a literary agent, it could take you a long time. It could take years. It could take 7 years. And maybe you'll be lucky and it'll only take months. But getting a literary agent usually does not happen quickly. If you're very lucky, it'll happen for you very soon, but it doesn't always happen that way. And then when you get a literary agent, there's more waiting, because then the literary agent has to pitch your book to different publishers, right? And that can take a long time as well. And then once you do finally get a publishing deal, you're not going to be, you know, the first book they publish. No, they've got a ton of other books that they need to publish. So you're going to be at the end of the line, and you're looking at maybe 2 years before you get your book out into the world. That's a long, long, long time to wait. And I couldn't wait that long. I didn't want to wait that long. Now, even if you don't have a literary agent, If you decide to go with a small press or like one of those publishers that doesn't require you to have a literary agent, it can still take a long, long time for this process to, you know, to get your book, you know, out into the world and out in bookstores and things like that. And so for me, what it ultimately came down to is, yes, there were reasons that I decided self-publishing was for me. I like having the control and things like that. But there was another reason, and that was I was tired of waiting for other people to make my dream come true. I was tired of waiting. I was tired of people saying no. And yes, okay, I got a lot of rejections. And I will say this, some of those rejections were pretty fair because, you know what, when I looked back at the story, it did have some problems and it just wasn't ready. You're right. Y'all were right. It wasn't ready. I think if I had queried One Big Mess, I would have got a literary agent. Like, I really believe that because I feel like that story was more ready than the other two stories that I queried. But that was so hard. That rejection was just so hard because it was like I wanted to have my book out into the world and they just kept saying no. They just kept saying no. And I realized I was just going to have to wait a super long time for me to get my book published. And I didn't want to wait. I did not want to wait. So I just wanted to say this. I'm happy that I decided to self-publish. I'm happy to be an indie author because now my book is out into the world. 2021 was the year that I could finally say I was a published author. And, you know, that old dream of mine of having a literary agent, you know, it just wasn't for me because I'm so happy and fulfilled that my book is out there. And, you know, if I had gotten a literary agent back in 2019, like, my book would probably still not be out there. And I wouldn't even be close to publishing anything else. Like this year in 2022, I am going to be publishing my second book. And publishing in the trad pub world, it is just not that fast. And I just want to get my book out there. I don't want to wait for anybody, you know, to help me. I don't want to wait for anybody out there to make that happen for me. You know what they say? Sometimes if you want something done, you just got to do it yourself. And so I am out there and I am doing it myself and I am so happy with my decision. I have no regrets about self-publishing. Is it hard? Yes. Does it cost money? Yes. But you know what? It's so worth it in the end because I'm so happy with my decision. And like I say, I'm not trying to say that it's better than trad pub. I have some friends that are, you know, trad pub and I have, you know, friends that are, you know, going that way, and that's totally fine because that's what's good for them, but it was not for me, and I'm so happy that I finally have my book out in the world, and I love that I have the freedom to publish whatever I want to publish. I don't have to answer to anybody. I don't have to make changes to my book because the editor at the publishing house doesn't think it's good enough, or, you know, I don't have to just let them decide what the cover is going to be. I get a say-so in what the cover looks like. And I don't have to share any of my royalties either. Well, you know, like, except like with Drafted Digital or like whoever I use. Of course, they take a small percentage, but I don't really have to share my royalties with anyone. Now, I don't get an advance, which is nice, but I just get my money on the back end. So it all works out in the end. So if you're thinking of self-publishing, if you are thinking that maybe it's the option for you, definitely explore it. I used to be against self-publishing. I know, me, a self-published author, I was like, oh, I'm never going to self-publish. Like, no, I'll get a literary agent. It'll be fine. Because I work in a library, and most of the books in the library that I work at, they are trad pub books. We do have some self-published books on the shelves, like mine, but it's mostly trad pub, and that's mostly what I have read my entire life. And, like, I kind of come from a fanfic writing background, because back then, like, when I was writing fanfic, I mean, like, anybody can write fanfic and post fanfic on the internet. And it's true, there's some fanfic that's not well written, but then, like, you find those gems out there, you know, those stories that are really, really good. And I always try to make my story is like really, really good because I wanted my story to be the best that it could be. And so I was always working to improve my craft and hone my writing skills. And so when I looked at self-publishing, I was like, anybody can self-publish, just like anybody can write fanfic. Oh gosh, like, you know, what if they think my story is horrible because it's self-published? But now I'm learning that more and more people are moving to self-publishing. It's a business thing, really. It's not always just, oh, I can't get an agent, I'm going to just self-publish. It's not always that. Some people are actively choosing to self-publish their book because they like the control factor, which I'm realizing I really love that control. All right, so I'm going to end this video now. Thank you so much for watching and leave me a comment. Let me know if self-publishing is for you and you want to try it out. Or let me know if you think TradPub is the way to go for you. Either is fine, but I'm so happy that I made the decision that I did. I don't have any regrets about it. And I'm excited for what comes next, so stay tuned. All right, I'll see y'all later. Bye.